in Italy with Spurs. 1-0 down and the players still won't get their finger out. Ironic really, because on the way into the ground, one of the stewards put one of his up mine. And when I tell my fellow supporters about it, they do this. Fuck you, football. No wonder we act like animals. Went to Florence. Difficult place to go, because Florence is in Europe, and the English aren't exactly welcome in Europe anymore. Racist, violent, drunken, fat, potato-headed wankers. Or, to give them their proper name, Chelsea fans. Leave work and meet Tim on the airport train, who claims that someone on Twitter has heard that there's an alcohol ban in the city because the Italians are worried that we might get drunk, and when we get drunk, we get racist, which, at the risk of sounding racist, is a bit fucking rich coming from them. Confirm the rumours by Google translating the front page of the Italian papers, then use it to learn how to say fuck off, and you are 35 and refuse to move out of your mother's house, which should come in handy later. Oh, and turns out Danny Rose is crap at being a left back. Huh, it's amazing what you can learn in the paper these days. Arrive at the airport, discover that Tim needs one of those little plastic bags because he's now a metrosexual, not that there's anything wrong with that, and head to the pub even though there's only about 6 minutes before our flight leaves. Have a couple and turn up with time to spare, because Ryanair have literally never been on time for anything. And spend the entire flight to Bologna wondering why the grown man next to me is playing a ripped off version of Angry Birds while making kissing noises. Arrive in Italy and queue for a taxi that takes us to a hotel where they asked us whether we booked a twin or a double room, which we only realise in the lift means, so, are you two gay or what? Check the room out, clog the bidet out with bog rolls, because, well, we're English, innit? Then head out and try and find a drink in the town that's quieter than the Emirates on match day. Give up and go to bed. Separate beds, what are you trying to say? And get up the next morning to head to the station. We've got an hour to kill before the train, so we wander around the town. Wonder what this place sells. And think back to the Italian guy on the flight who says the bolognese was invented by the English, which is ironic because the whole fucking city stinks of it. Tim searches for a bottle shop to try and get around the alcohol ban in Florence and has to settle for a bottle of liqueur like he was your gran or something. Get on the train and arrive in Florence. Spend 15 minutes getting lost and eventually find our hotel, where they only give us one room key, which is basically their way of saying, okay. Dump our bags, Tim cracks into limoncello, which looks like something you drain out of someone's knee, and we head into town. Florence is very old and narrow, full of weirdly painted churches, and you can sort of understand why they don't want us pissing all over it. All the bars in the square are shut, so we head to an empty restaurant where Tim orders a beer that would kill Gaza. And I get some authentic Italian cuisine known as pizza de chips, which literally translates as pizza with chips on it. Wander around the main square with all the statues in it and think, what's with all the dicks? I mean, look at this guy. Someone's made that and thought, yeah, needs a cape and a hat. When actually what it really needs is less dick. Here's some Spurs in Duomo Square, just past the 600 blokes selling selfie sticks. Offer a quick prayer in the cathedral to cure Eric Lamella, who suffers from a condition called being shit, and head to a bar that is cleverly getting around the alcohol ban by serving beer in coffee cups. Have a few, then head towards the special buses to the ground, which is special because they're twice as shit as any other bus I've ever been on, and ring the bell all the way to the ground because, yeah, I'm English, before arriving outside of security with several busloads of people who've all magically managed to get extremely pissed. Wait ages to get through the security gates, and then get patted down around the man spuds before, no word of a lie, the steward sticks a quick finger right up my arse. I'm about to make a big deal out of it, but then don't, because I don't want to get shoved in a police van and worn like sooty. Still in shock as we get into the ground, so tweet the club and calculate the exact number of fucks given as zero. Tell a few people I thought were friends, and they react like this. Someone claims he's heard of stewards doing that because that's where Italian fans hide their flares. But call me a traditionalist, you don't set fire to something you've recently had up your arse. And the game kicks off and I'm still traumatised, although do you know what, I think they could have stripped and beaten me in the centre circle and I reckon I still would have played better than Vlad Kirakesh. And just as I'm coming to terms with it, Soldado is through and he's only got the keeper to beat and, do you know what, leave our club. And even though we're still in it, there's a feeling that with Bobby Soldier, Vlad the Lad and Ben Davis, how can you possibly win? I mean, I'm sure they're all nice people, but they're like free newspapers. They sort of do the job, but if you had to pay £26 million for one, you'd be pretty pissed off. Right on cue, all three of them stand by and watch as Fiorentina take the lead. And even though we've travelled across Europe, put up with the Vauxhall Conference Standard Ground and the toilet that smells like it was plumbed by Joseph Fritzl, even though we've been molested by men in high vis, none of this impresses Fazio, who falls over and lets Fiorentina score again and we're out. It's about 4 minutes left before we finally have a shot on goal, by which time my story is spread and half the Spurs enders decided it'd be funny to try and bum me with a blow-up dolphin. And as the stadium clears and it starts to rain and the police shove us onto crowded buses, I think, you know what, I've got no complaints. Because this is how it works when you go away to Europe. You act up, you say and do things you'd never do at home, and in exchange you get knocked about by the police, and if you're really unlucky, a steward's finger up your chuff. Because they may kick in our back doors, they may try and unblock our pipes, but they'll never take what remains of our dignity. Because we're the soundtrack to this game, we're its heart, its conscience. Without us, it's nothing. And then a week later we're 2-0 down at Wembley and the row in front of us is beating the shit out of each other. And do you know what? Maybe we are just a bunch of animals after all. It's all swings and roundabouts, isn't it? I'm still an animal.